So lighter than 47 grams, here we go.
This video is sponsored by Solvol with the new 3D printer, the SV06 Plus.
The other day I was mindlessly scrolling on Twitter and came across this post from Nero3D with this skeletonized gantry being folded. And I was like, what the fuck? Why are you doing this?
That wasn't mine. So to be fair, that was somebody on the Discord that twisted their experience.
This is Taylor, also known as Nero3D, and he is part of the Voron team. His tweet about skeletonized gantries sparked an idea, and when I asked him about these skeletonized gantries, he said this.
People in the community kind of started coming up with those, and those kind of all started around the whole speed benchy thing.
Yeah.
Because people wanted to go light, to go fast. So nothing in the world is free. Okay, so if you want to print fast, you gotta increase your accelerations. Well, you increase your accelerations, you start getting ringing in your print. Okay, well, we can use input shaper. We can get rid of ringing with input shaper. But the more input shaper you throw at it, you start rounding edges of your print. So a sharp corner starts becoming a round corner. There's always going to be take and give when it comes to a way you design. Now, if you want to go the lightest gantry, just use the rail. Why not just use the rail? Because you need the motion system by itself. So that's going to always be the light.
47 grams. If you want to make something light and something stiff, you'll end up with a shape that sort of looks like this. This is what you also see with cranes. Or in my case, where I got the inspiration from, with a truss. A truss is often used to build stages, and these are very stiff and lightweight. And a truss consists only of triangles. The design consists out of these individual segments, and they are just mounted together with these threaded rods. Maybe we can turn this into a whole ecosystem, like a system design, like Legos. We have seen this already in the 3D printing world with Stampy, or with poly panels from Make Anything, or the Miranda blocks from Ivan Miranda. And these are built out of basic blocks, which have a specific set of rules, which can be put together with ease to create awesome stuff. This isn't easy, and I'm going to show you in a minute how not easy this is. Let's put one together, and then I'm going to introduce you to the rest of this design. And putting one of these together is fairly simple. I've printed a bunch of these segments out of fluorogreen PLA from three different makers, and I think that this looks pretty interesting. And I've got these M3 threaded rods at a length of 250 millimeters. Now you put this together, it's important to keep a bit of pressure here on the sides, because it doesn't slide on this threaded rod. More details about how this is put together and which parts you need can be found on my website. I'm using these standoffs on either side, so we can mount things to this. And when fastening these, it's the easiest to do it on the edge of a table, so you can hold it down, because it has the tendency to pop out of here. And if you just try to bend it a couple of times, then you will see that it will get further in shape, and you can fasten it a bit more. And that's one segment done. I've prepared a couple of them, and this idea started out as being a gantry, but I think that we can take this one step further and turn this into a design system, meaning that we have to somehow couple these together to build stuff. I want to see if I can make a frame with this. So I've designed a couple of corner pieces. And this is where the fun begins. If you want to connect two of them, it's not only the angle that is a variable, it's also this angle. Well, they are a triangle, so we can connect them like this, or maybe like this, or this, or this. And if you add a third one, then we have even more parameters. There's also a left and right version, by the way. And the amount of possibilities are... Oh, I've made an Excel file with the current possibilities, and I'm going to design new ones when I need them. Right now, I just need two variants to make this frame. If I need more, it's a parametric file, so I can modify a couple of parameters. And these corner pieces, they look pretty difficult to print, but the opposite is true. These can even be printed without using support. Putting this together is pretty satisfying because this is quite a snug fit. If this idea turns out to be a terrible idea, then at least it looks cool. Okay. Okay, this is pretty stiff. So, but now we have to add some kind of gantry, and that's the reason why these threaded rods are exposed. These threaded rods act as rails for this carriage. These rollers, they should run smoothly over these threaded rods. I hope it will just act a bit like a helicopter gears, which are gears with teeth at an angle. This bearing here has an inner diameter of 3 millimeters. This whole pattern should allow this the end of these gantries to be placed in 4 orientations. I still have to print this carriage, and we are going to do that on the printer that has been made by the sponsor of this video, Soval, with their new SV06 Plus.
After Soval's very successful launch of the SV06, they just launched a bigger and even better printer, the SV06 Plus. It has an intuitive touch interface, and with the 25-point active bed leveling system, you're ensured of the perfect first layer. The all-metal direct drive planetary gear extruder has a high ratio for accurate extrusion, and the all-metal hot end with a large melt zone can go up to 300 degrees. The print speed of 150 millimeters per second is the default printing speed, which is fast. All rails are beefed up for better performance, and it has a filament runout sensor with a resume function. The PEI build surface makes it very easy to remove your finished print. Ready for the next one. All green parts you see in this video are printed with this SV06 Plus. Soval also gives an exclusive discount, so check out the link in the description for more information.
Okay, I printed the carriages and I tried putting one together. And well, this definitely was not an easy job. There are 3 parts that are sort of being held together with only the screws. And then I realized that I do not even need 2/3 of this carriage, because one carriage should be able to do the job if the gantry is in between there, so it cannot go anywhere. Our goal was to make the gantry as light as possible. But using these threaded rods, steel is not known for being the lightest material. Right now this gantry is around 56 grams. It's not the lightest solution out there, especially considering, well, these extremely light gantries. It's not a very fair comparison because this gantry is bigger than the gantry for the forehand. Okay, these threaded rods alone weigh more than 28 grams. I didn't even know that it existed, but I bought aluminum threaded rods, M3, and that's extremely light, 11 grams. 11 and a half. This is much lighter than the steel rod. And now it weighs 38 and a half grams. But the problem with aluminum is that it's pretty weak, and I have to tension this in order to, well, make it stiff. I was afraid of destroying this thread, so I made this simple tool, which I call pretensioners. And I can just place them on both ends. And I can use this clamp to pretension it. Fortunately, we have to do this only once. Okay, and now if I loosen the clamp, this gantry is not straight. It's incredibly tough to make it straight. I don't think aluminum is going to do the trick, but I also bought titanium threaded rods. Titanium, it's basically the best of both worlds, because it's lighter than steel, and it's extremely stiff. It's much stronger than aluminum, and it also looks better because it has this dark tint to it. I also bought titanium screws and nuts. I also bought these seal washers. These are conical washers, so the washers do not interfere with the bearings, so I can tighten them better. I also managed to make these seal washers myself by pressing them into shape. I did that a couple of times because it took a while for these to come in, but I've received them and these work pretty great. I've printed the wheels out of ABS with a 0.2 millimeter nozzle, and I've tightened them and they roll very smooth. So I think that the combination of seal washers and bearings is a nice one. I don't know if this is common practice, but it works pretty good. Let me just put it together quickly. After moving it back and forth a couple of times, it's still not as smooth as I was hoping it would be, but it is sort of smooth. I'm going to be completely honest with you. Besides this not going as smooth as I hoped, it fits so well within this threaded rod that individual segments, they get left behind within the thread. This is not a good solution. However, I do have another idea in mind, which I will show you a bit later. But first, I want to see if at least this gantry is lighter than the original gantry, to be sure that this is not a complete failure. So lighter than 47 grams, here we go. Oh, fuck me. Okay, it's not lighter. It's not running better. It's not more durable. It's not easy to work with. It's also not cheaper, but it looks cooler. So nevertheless, I'm going to put everything together and see how it runs. I do have an idea how to optimize this, but first let's just quickly put this together.
In the meantime, I want to say special thanks to these guys, my top tier Patreon supporters. Your support helps a lot with these projects.
Okay, well, it does look awesome. That's something that... This is not a failure, but there is room for improvement. I think I've got a couple of ideas that could be very interesting. First of all, and that's the biggest flaw of this, and that is this roller. I was wondering if it would be possible to make a smooth roller with these threaded rods. It's not terrible. Well, it is terrible. I've done a quick search and I found these track rollers. And it looks like the purpose of these things are... pretty much tailored for a solution like this. I think it would be interesting to try this system with track rollers, but with not with threaded rods, but with smooth rods, maybe out of titanium or steel, but hollow. But I have to cut thread on the opposite ends to tighten everything. I think it could be interesting to do some research on how to print as light as possible while remaining stiffness. I also think that it would look insanely cool to eventually turn this into a complete working printer. My question to you is this something that you would like to see in a future video? Shall I figure out if he can print as light as possible and take a dive into the world of speed benches to print as fast as possible and see how far we can push this? Or maybe this is an interesting thing to scale up, to make a big printer. Is this a subject that you want to see in a future video? So please let me know in the comments. And if not, then I'm going to work on another project.